dangerous. If you're one of us, then roll with us, cause we make the hipsters fall in love when we got our hot pants on and up. And yes, of course we does. We run in this town just like a club. And no, you don't wanna mess with us. Got Jesus on my necklace.
Well, ever since her 2010 debut record, Animal, Kesha has taken the world by storm. And in what will be music to the ears of her fans, she's back with a new record and here to tell us all about it. Kesha, welcome to BPM.
Thank you.
Firstly, let's start off where we last saw you. It was at the end of your Get Sleazy tour last year. And then you took a little bit of time off. Is that right?
I did.
Of a spiritual journey?
Yeah, I went on a bit of a spirit journey because I'd been on tour for like 2.5 years. And when you're on tour, you're surrounded by so many people all the time. So I wanted to just kind of go off by myself for a minute.
And then when did you start working on the new album?
And I started working, I just went off for like, you know, a little over a month. And then I had people really up my ass to get back in the studio. So then I got back in the studio and have been there ever since for like the past 9 months.
Live it up. I'm so sick of being so serious. It's making my brain delirious. I'm just talking true.
Let's start with kind of inspirations for you, first of all. Were you inspired by that kind of spirit journey that you went on? Were you writing while you were still touring? When did it all sort of start?
Yeah, I'm always writing. Like, I'll write even in my sleep, and I'll like write things on my hand, and I'll wake up and be like, what in the hell does that even mean? But so I'm always constantly writing, and I was inspired by my tour, and my fans inspired me a lot. But this like spirit journey I went on inspired me. That's where I came up with the title Warrior.
Okay, great.
And also just my fans really inspired that, because I feel like I've heard so many stories around the world of my fans that had to go through some sort of crisis and had to really fight to be themselves through something. And I wanted them to feel like they're all warriors, because I feel like that's something we all have inside of ourselves. Either we could be a victim or we can be a warrior. And I wanted to inspire that in my fans.
Wake up in the morning feeling like P. Diddy.
Hey, what up, girl?
Grab my glasses, I'm out the door. I'm gonna hit this city.
Let's
before
go.
I leave, brush my teeth with a bottle of Jack. Cause when I leave for the night, I ain't coming back.
Now, Animal's kind of regarded as a really fun sort of party record.
Yes.
What would you say the theme of Warrior is?
I like to say magic.
Okay.
Because I hope it's a really magical record, like the magic of life, because there are party songs, but there's also songs about ghosts and regressing into a past life experience, which is something I did, and my car that's like a metal, like, beast of an American-made car, and I don't know, I just write about all sorts of crazy shit, so I want to write about the magic of life.
The regressing into a past life experience, what's that all about?
I was just reading when I went on the spirit journey, I went off by myself and read all these books by this hypnotherapist, and then I wanted to try it, and then I did, and it really blew my mind open. So then I wanted to write a song about it. I write songs about everything though. Like, there's nothing that's off limits.
I read that you wrote 200 songs, I think it was, to start with for Animal. That's a huge song pool. Did you use any of those kind of old tracks for Warrior, or how big was the song pool this time around?
I probably wrote around 40 or 50.
Wow.
But no, I didn't really go back. I wanted to write all new stuff.
Yeah.
And I really wanted to push myself, like, I wanted to write even crazier and even dancier and even more rock and roll and even like more vulnerable and raw. I really just wanted to push myself in all sorts of directions. And I have some really amazing collaborators. I don't know if you know.
Yeah, well, that's you're such a go-getter when it comes to collaborators. I think
you mean I'm a stalker.
Well, the Prince story is a classic. I think it's such a beautiful story about you busting in to his house and sort of giving him your demo. It's a great story. And then again, this time around, yeah, please tell us who you've collaborated
with. Yeah, I've been stalking. I'm a busy girl. I wanted to work with Iggy Pop because he's like, Mark Bolan and Iggy Pop are like the two people that I have on repeat all the time. So I really wanted to work with him, and I've been stalking him for years. And finally I was like, I finally got to him. I was like, let's just do it. And he was down. And he was like the most amazing human on the planet. So I'm really proud of that collaboration.
And so in what way did you work with him on this record?
We wrote a song together called Dirty Love.
Awesome.
And we're just screaming. It's so fun.
A bowl of whiskey in my handbag.
Kesha, that you were sort of saying maybe the record would almost be rock and roll at one stage. Is that true?
There are moments. Okay. Like, that's the thing, is I kind of had to figure out how far to push myself in every direction. But I love living on pop radio. Like, I love pop music. Yeah. I know some people think pop is a dirty word, but for me, like, I love pop music and I will till I die. But I wanted to like bring guitar and I wanted to scream a little bit and I wanted to work with some of my favorite rock idols like Iggy Pop and the Flaming Lips and Ben Folds is a friend of mine and
Black Keys.
Amazing. And Julian Casablancas from The Strokes. So there's like a long list of really amazing people that I got to work with on this record.
So while you're here in my arms, let's make the most of the night like we're gonna die young.
The first single from the album is called Die Young. Mm-hmm. What can you tell us about that?
Well, Die Young, I really like Die Young. I hope Australia does too, because it's just my philosophy on living. Like, I try to live every day as if it could be my last, because you never know. So I think everyone should just live right now.
And is there a video for the song? Because there's a lyric video, I think, that we can sort of look at online at the moment. Yeah. Are you working on an actual official video?
Yeah, the video should be out any day now.
That's exciting.
Yeah, I know.
Can you tell us anything about it?
Well, it's about me. I'm like a cult leader. And I have my group of my rabid misfit cult. And we have to run away from the law. And we end up in a border town in Mexico.
Oh, wow.
Just being completely debaucherous.
As you would expect. In Mexico in a border town. So, what about, is there a favorite track on the record? I mean, so many amazing collaborators. Is there one that you just love and is very, very dear to you?
I think the one with Iggy Pop, like, okay. I love hearing it because I also just scream like a crazy banshee. It's really fun. And then there's a song called Love Into the Light, which is a more emotional, raw, vulnerable moment. But I wrote that for my fans.
Oh, so beautiful.
It's like a sweet song.
What you got, boy, is hard to find.
We love having you in Australia. You've obviously had great success with your tour in 2011. Can we hope to see you back here?
Absolutely.
Maybe
I love it
year?
Here. Oh, yes. I can't wait to come back here. Like, I'm obsessed with it here. Like, the weather and the people and the accent and everything. I just love it here. I want you guys to just adopt me.
What's coming up next for you?
Well, I actually have a lot of things up my sleeve.
Yes.
So I've been making this record, but I've also been putting together like a photo book for my fans called My Crazy Beautiful Life, which is just a backstage pass to everything, like really just balls on the table, everything. I have a fake fur line coming out because I'm really heavily involved in animal rights.
Of course, yeah.
And I think if anybody wants to look really amazing and wear fake fur, it's cheaper and nicer. So I want to give my fans the option for that. I'm designing jewelry.
Wow, busy girl.
Yeah, lots of stuff.
And all the information about those things can be found on your website,
yeah.
I presume?
Yeah.
Awesome.
Yeah, and you can check me out on Twitter. It's twitter.com/KeshaSucks.
Yep. We will do that. Funny Twitter name for you then, because she doesn't suck.
Now, beat the haters to the punchline.
Yeah, absolutely. I should say, of course, you can download Die Young now at bigpommusic.com or stream it via Mog. And your beautiful new record is out from November 30, which is very exciting.
I know, Kesha, I'm very excited.
Yeah, thank you so much. It's great to speak with you.
You too.
It's been really wonderful. Thank you.
Thanks.
Hey. So. Your beard.